What a terrific day. I'm having cascading revelations, just one after the other like this, which is fantastic because that's exactly what we need right now. We need to go really, really fast. And that is exactly what's happening. And so far, so good. So welcome everyone to this video. The recent revelation that started this was I called the old sewer pipe revelation. It was taking old sewer pipes to the dump. What could be more lowly than that? And yet still asking for help and clarification. Give me ultimate clarification right now. Wow. And boom, it happened. I saw that all suffering was just an attempt to induce guilt in and displace the prime creator. We're trying to induce guilt in so that this displaces the prime creator. The prime creator says, I can't stand this guilt. I don't want to be prime creator anymore. All suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and displace the prime creator. Wow. All suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and displace the prime creator. Wow. So this was just a driving to the dump with this truck full of old sewer pipes from a house, all sewer pipes, the most grungy thing imaginable, right? I'm saying, hey, now's the great time for revelation, right? Great time for a breakthrough, isn't it? Yes. So that's our April 20th old sewer pipe revelation. Which is backing up the February 10th car wash revelation. Well, in the car wash. So there's wonderful places these revelations are happening. It's just a massive expansion of our recognition and understanding and a fresh viewpoint of that is fantastically helpful, because in these times, we could see the world's going down the wrong road. It's going down a really bad road. And we say, we don't want to go down that road. You could see that's going to bring about terrible trouble. So with this newest revelation, the old sewer pipe revelation, April 20th, wow, all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and displace the prime creator, trying to make the prime creator, induce guilt in the prime creator, and thereby causing the prime creator to abdicate. So all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of the prime creator and abdication of the prime creator. All suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of the prime creator or the prime creatoring. Wow. Now, from this, another revelation came this morning, and that is that don't try to cure suffering, renounce suffering. So we've shifted from curing suffering to renouncing suffering. And this is like extremely significant, because it really means we're not going to put our future in the hands of the pharmaceutical companies going down that road. That would be trying to cure suffering. Okay, that's not the right approach at all. The right approach is to renounce suffering, okay? Is to renounce suffering. So don't try to cure suffering. No curing suffering, just renouncing suffering. Wow, just shocked by no curing but renouncing suffering. Wow, just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow, just allowing renouncing all suffering. Wow, just accepting renouncing all suffering. Wow, just delighting in renouncing all suffering. Wow, just loving renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just abiding in renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. So renounce all suffering. Don't try to cure it. The road of trying to cure suffering is not the right road to go down. The road of renouncing suffering is the road to go down. We are intentionally imagining all this suffering in order to induce guilt in and abdication of the prime creator. We want the Prime Creator to feel so much guilt about our suffering that the Prime Creator renounces being Prime Creator, says, I can't take the guilt anymore of this. So we're simply it's an effort we're making to displace the Prime Creator. All suffering is our effort to displace the Prime Creator. So curing suffering, what is that? It's just so another suffering can take its place. That's not the answer. Renounce suffering. Very, very important distinction between curing suffering and renouncing suffering. Same thing with samsaric delusion, maya, sin, all the, you know. Renounce samsara. Don't cure it. Don't get enlightened from it. Don't do it. Renounce it. It's samsara is an effort to induce guilt in and abdication of the Prime Creatoring. That's exactly what it is. Same with maya. Maya is effort to induce guilt in and abdication of Prime Creatoring. So if there are efforts, what do? Renounce our efforts. Renounce our efforts. Renounce it. Wow, just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just accepting renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just allowing renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just accepting renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just delighting in renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just loving renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just abiding in renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Renounce all suffering. Say, I give it up. I repent. I renounce it. I say no. That's called renunciation. Genuine renunciation is the renunciation of all suffering, all delusion. We're doing it intentionally, imagining all suffering. We're the ones imagining it to try to induce guilt in the Prime Creator so the Prime Creator abdicates being Prime Creator so we can be the new Prime Creator. This is the heart and soul of these new revelations, these series of revelations, these cascading revelations that are happening now. And you could feel, wow, this is getting us up to speed. We're going really fast, really fast. And that's what that white Corvette was all about. It blew my doors off on the freeway, went past me like I was standing still. I was probably going 130, but totally under control. It was amazing that those new Corvettes, boy, that car was just tracking like beautifully. And I didn't get mad. I just said, what's this about? Well, what it's about is showing that we have to go really fast right now, but it's safe. It's safe. The Corvette wasn't out of control or anything like that. They knew what they were doing. And the driver knew that the car could handle that speed. Aerodynamically, there wasn't going to get any air underneath the car. You know, everything is, the car is built to go really, really fast. It'd be different if some other type of car was going, like an SUV was going that fast. That would be really dangerous. But we're built for speed, actually. We're built to go really fast right now. And anything less than that is going to be quite a failure. It's because the road, the low road to hell is really being rolled out, you know, as this is the thing. Celebrities are getting behind it. You know, everybody's getting behind it. And it's an entire package of, you know, lowliness. It's a road we don't want to go down. So we have to go fast to not get caught up in the momentum of this low road. And we are going fast. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just shocked by the renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing. We can say that. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just allowing renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just accepting renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just delighting in renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just loving renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just abiding in renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. So don't go down the path of trying to cure your suffering. Cure this suffering. Cure this. This has caused me too much trouble. Let me cure this, only for, you know, other sufferings to come along. I got to take this vaccine, then I got to take another, and then I got a booster shot. Oh, another virus is coming along. Oh, another vaccine for that booster shot. You know, drugs, medicine, medications. Just, you know, we're going down this road, aren't we? Instead, we take the high road of just simply renouncing all suffering. I renounce all suffering. Well, just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Suffering is intentional. It's It's our own intention. It's imaginative. We're imagining our suffering. We're doing it on purpose. It's totally intentional and totally imaginal. Imaginal. How do you say it? It's from our imagination. Intentional. There isn't really a word imaginal. Is there imaginal? Yeah, imaginal. So we're totally responsible for it. Totally responsible for it. And so we have to give up the purpose of it. We must renounce the purpose of suffering. There's only one purpose for suffering. That is to ultimately induce guilt in and displace the prime creator because of that guilt. And so we must not try to fidget around and say, well, there's a virus. Well, let's get a vaccination so we don't get the virus. You know, that's not good. There's another virus. Maybe we can hold off the suffering for a bit, and manipulate it and then manipulate the suffering. That's not renunciation of suffering. That's not renouncing the purpose of suffering. That's the same old, same old, same old, same old, same old. So we have this wonderful breakthrough right now of just renounce all suffering. I'm just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just accepting, renouncing all suffering. Wow. Skip the allowing to. Just allowing, renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just accepting, renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just delighting in renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just loving, renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just abiding and renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just 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 renouncing all suffering. Wow. So you have to start going along this road. It's like that. It's like going along a road. You turn onto road and say, whoa, this is a different direction. This looks interesting. Yeah. And then you start going down that road. And so the practicing we do is helping us go down this road, go along this road. Go along this road, and we get more and more familiar. We're like, oh yeah, I could just, the answer really to all suffering is to renounce all suffering. Just renounce it. Since it's all coming from us, our imagination, our willful imagination, all suffering is coming from that, and it's all imaginary. So we have the power to renounce it. We can simply renounce it. Simply renounce all suffering. Wow. So this is the road that has been hidden for so long in this world. Certainly the pharmaceutical interests have tried to hide this road. They've tried their utmost to hide this road. Right? Yeah. And that's why they're warring against religion, trying to destroy it. Because religion at least hints about this road. There's kind of some hints, and it starts kind of helping you go a little bit in that direction. It's religion is largely depleted in this world from all the attempts to undermine it, termite it, you might say. But here we are with the fresh exposition of this, just beautiful, scintillating and fresh, just wow, just shocked by renouncing all suffering, wow. Renouncing all suffering, not fixing it, not curing it, not doing anything with it, just simply renouncing all of it, renouncing the purpose for it, renouncing the purpose, which is to induce guilt in and bring about abdication of the prime creator. So we cannot displace the prime creator. So our strategy is to try to get the prime creator to displace itself, to renounce itself, saying, I'm no good. I'm no good. I'm renouncing myself. That's the strategy of suffering, is to produce guilt in the prime creator. Look what you're doing to me. You created me and look how bad I'm suffering. What an incompetent prime creator you are. See, it's a strategy we're using. That's all it is. All our suffering is just a strategy that we are utilizing. It's all our imagination. We're just conjuring up this imaginary suffering. But we're very good at imagining. We're so creative. It seems vividly real to us. Vividly real to us in so many ways. But at any point we can renounce it all. At any point, we can renounce it all. We don't need to do anything to cure it because we can renounce all of it. If we can renounce all suffering this instant, why do we need to be struggling with some cure for, like, well, I need to get this cancer, like, you know, under control or something like that? But if we can renounce all suffering this instant, again, why worry too much about struggling? We got to figure out a way to cure this, got to cure this, got to cure this, got to cure this. So I was never interested in cures in this world. I said, no, that's not the answer. I don't take medicines. I don't go to doctors. I'm not interested in curing anything. People say, there's something wrong with you. You're not interested in curing stuff? Must be a really negative person. No, I'm a super positive person, because I'm saying the key to all suffering is to renounce all suffering. Renounce all suffering. To renounce all suffering. So these folks are taking us on this low road. It's a consortium of all sorts of people, actually, with their own, you know, agendas. They're really bringing us on the road to much worse suffering, okay? Extreme suffering. Folks that are in charge of the world right now, who have the power and are pushing these agendas, they're this is the low road to hell, meaning worse suffering, intense suffering. And if you've already been through intense suffering, you don't want to do it anymore, because it doesn't work. It doesn't displace the prime creator. It certainly doesn't. And so you realize, well, this is a road to nowhere. It's intense suffering that won't work at all. You know, you just say, oh my gosh, I did all this for nothing. Yeah. So here we have the right alternative, which is the goal on the road of just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. All suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of the prime creator. Wow. All suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of the prime creator. Wow. Of prime creatoring. Wow. All suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just shocked by all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just allowing all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just accepting that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just delighting that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just loving all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just abiding in all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creating. Wow. Just all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creating. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just allowing renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just accepting renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just delighting in renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just loving renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just abiding in renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing of all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing of all suffering. Wow. So it is a great day. What's the day? I don't even know what the date is. It's the 22nd. So we had the old sewer pipe revelation, cascading revelation, and then from this revelation has really become really, really clear. Just renounce all suffering. Renounce all suffering. That's the April 22nd. It's part of that old sewer pipe revelation. What a perfect time for it. You know what I'm saying? Are you kidding me? This is where I am in the world, you know? Like, so the plumber took out all the old sewer pipes and busted them up with a sledgehammer. And I loaded them into a truck. Heavy stuff, you know, and grimy. Just, it's like, oh, wow, you know. But taking them to the dump. Have to take them out, throw them out. And it's like, you know. So this is life. This is life. This is life. I said, you know what? I'm open to let's go down a better road than just taking old sewer pipes out of houses. Well, maybe that's metaphoric about, you know, we've got to look at suffering a different way, right? So yeah, renounce all suffering. renounce all suffering. Just get this into your heart, you know, into your spirit, into your core, into your familiarity. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Encapsulate all evaluation of this, all assessment is wow. I know how to assess this. I am assessing it by wow. So this prevents us from thinking about, it keeps us, enables us to keep practicing. If we don't use the wow encapsulation, we'll start thinking about, like, you know, what is this about? And our thoughts will start wandering all over the place, right? Well, if we say just renouncing all suffering, wow, meaning I got it. I got the assessment of it. I know exactly what the assessment is, and I have it. It's perfect assessment, and it's wow. So they say, okay, I got that. And I go back and say, just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. I have the assessment. Otherwise, they'll say, well, how do I assess this? How do I assess this? And then you lose the momentum of your practicing. You see, so the effectiveness of the practicing, which has been leading to these revelations that I've had, is because of the wow. The encapsulating, the practicing. It's practicing, but it's encapsulated practicing. We're encapsulating all assessment of our practicing. It's kind of like a practicing golf game, which I've been doing. I've done it 4 out of the last 6 days I've been practicing. And it's all short game stuff. It's all chipping and pitching. And did bunker yesterday. And it's like you ask, well, are you making progress? I say, I don't know. I mean, I'm making progress while practicing. I can see progress in my practicing. Does that mean progress on the golf course? I don't know. I can't say that. It's different. It's a different fish, different situation out there. And will the progress last? I can't say that. But while I'm practicing, you know, I'm getting better. So when we do these practicing like this, you can feel yourself getting better. Wow. Just shocked by all guilt. All guilt is an attempt to induce. All suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. So starting out this morning, it was very difficult. I first had to fashion this practice and then start doing it. But now I'm like better at it. Just shocked by all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. So you'd say, like, wow, yeah, that's pretty good. The same thing like golf. That's a nice pitch shot. I was doing pitch shots yesterday with like a 1-to-1 ratio, meaning the off the green distance, like 10 yards, is the same as from the edge of the green to the pin. It's 10 yards from the edge of the green to the pin, and I'm 10 yards back off that edge of the green in the rough. And so, I mean, you know, how do you hit those pitch shots? Oh, 60-degree wedge. And how do you get it to go up in the air, pop it up in the air, and give the right trajectory? Well, you've got to follow through with your swing towards the pin, the target, and don't just try to stop down by the ball. You have to sort of follow through, and that gives the ball, pops it up like that. And so I was getting better and better and better in that. Then went into the bunker and did sand work, and was doing better and better and better and better at that too. And everything I was doing, I was getting better and better and better at it while practicing. And the same thing with spiritual practicing is you'll feel that it's smoothing out for you and you're getting better at it. Now, you know, as far as ultimacy, we can't say that. I can't say, am I becoming a better golfer? I can't say that. I'm not trying to say that. I just know I'm consistently practicing, and while I'm practicing, I'm refining what I'm doing. I can see, you know, okay, let's try this. Okay, now this is working a lot better than when I started. And, you know, just do that. Just live with that. I enjoy doing that. I enjoy the spiritual practicing. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just enjoy doing that. Enjoy it. And get better and better and better at that. So you just feel it's smooth. It's really ingrained. I'm familiar with it. And, you know, the next down the road, there'll be another practice, which is even better, you might say, if that's possible. But just renouncing all suffering is a pretty fantastically great practice. But don't try to extrapolate. Well, what am I going to do in the world? How am I going to be this and this? Forget it. You have to forget it. I don't even think about playing golf. I don't even think about it. Not even thinking about it. I'm just thinking about practicing. I love practicing. I love practicing because you can see improvement. You can see improvement. On a golf course, you don't see improvement. It's pretty much survival out there. It's survival because you only have one chance at every shot. And so you're just struggling to hopefully hold your game together and not, you know, doesn't fall apart, basically, is what it is. Unless you just play, you know, twice every day of your life. And some people play so much that they can actually start dialing stuff in pretty well. But for most people, they're just saying, I hope I don't fall apart out here. But when we're practicing, I mean, I can hit these pitch shots. I hit 20 of them, pick up the balls, hit 20 more, pick up the balls, hit 20 more, like that. And different distances that I did a 5-10 ratio, which is, you know, half one ratio, 5 yards off the green and 10 yards to the pin. I was using like a 52 wedge. And then I was going on a little hill, so it's a side hill thing, and then side hill in the rough, and seeing how the ball pops out, and, you know, how to manage these tricky situations and stuff like that, and just trying all sorts of little different situations, little variations, and seeing that, getting better and better and better. So that's rewarding. So these practices kind of like reward us, because we get better at them as we do it. When I start off in the morning trying to fashion these practices, you know, it's a struggle. It's a struggle. It's like, whoops, that wasn't so good. Same thing with the golf. It's like, you know, wow, I'm not doing so good right now. Okay, how can I do better? Okay, let me look at stuff. What am I doing? You know, okay, the follow through. Okay. And then eventually, you know, like the first 20 was lousy, all short. I couldn't pop it properly, you know, pop the ball and get it going. And it wasn't following through. And as soon as I started following through, the ball rolls out another 5 yards, right? You know, or right where the pin is. So it's practicing, you know, you just have to keep doing it and get better at it. Say, wow, this is just shocked by all suffering. Is an attempt to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just shocked at all suffering is an attempt to produce guilt in an abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. So that's a very difficult practice. It's an extremely difficult practice. It's like trying to hit a flop shot out of rough, like with like a 2-1 ratio. You're like twice as far off the green as the pin is from the edge of the green. So, you know, you just have to like try to just pop the ball almost straight up on this very high trajectory and then just let it come plop down out of rough. Very difficult shot. But it's doable. It's doable. And it's practicing, and I was able to do it. But when you're playing in golf, if you have one chance to hit that shot and you're like saying, oh my God, I don't screw this up. And you screw it up then. Right? Unless you're playing so much, say, I've done this shot so many times. I know I can make this one. Okay, let's just get it right and, you know, see how the club's going through this grass. You know, do I need to gouge down into it or just sweep through it? Make sure I get the little leg action, you know, and then follow through, you know, and make sure, you know, check the trajectory, you know, make sure the case slide out of the trajectory and just the right. I mean, there's all sorts of slightly open and you know, firm grip, so, you know, you don't lose. You really got to go, really got to pop through it. And there's all sorts of stuff. But you got to put it all together like in a smooth sequence. Just here's the smooth whole thing, smooth sequence. You can't glitch any part. You can't say, wait a minute, that might not be right. There's no time to stop. You know, you just have to go for it and do it. And sometimes it works. So this is a tough practice, for sure, really tough. But you can see, you know, just shocked by all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creatoring. Wow, just like that, yeah. Just shocked that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creatoring. Wow, just shocked that all guilt is an attempt to induce guilt. Just shocked that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creatoring. Wow, just shocked that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. So this is kind of like hitting a flop shot of a half one ratio. I mean, a 1-2 ratio. A 1-2 ratio. The one is the distance from the edge of the green to the pin, and the two is the distance between the edge of the green and how far away you are. So like a 1-2 is real tough. Like a 5, the pin's 5 yards off, you know, off the edge of the green, and you're 10 yards in the rough. You got to land it like right on the fringe with a super high trajectory and boop, and then it just kind of, you know, trickles towards the hole like that. You know, it's just like the toughest shot there is, basically, unless it's on a side hill, downhill, or, you know, something like that, which makes it, you know, all the more difficult. But when you get it, it's like, yeah, you know, like, wow, that's cool. Anybody see that? Nah, nobody's paying attention. Everybody's paying attention to what they're doing. I was there yesterday, and the greens are so fast. It's like Augusta, Masters Augusta. And the pins, they're putting like a little hill right before the pin. And then right after the pin, the green just slopes off so fast. And if you go past the hole at all, the ball's going to trickle away, you know, 20 feet away. And so you have to stop it. Go up the hill and stop it before it starts going down. It's like it was just like brutally difficult. It's like, holy, but I mean, I'd hit like 50 shots, you know, trying to get it, that kind of thing. I don't give up easy. I'll get it. And finally I started, you know, getting some really good shots. And guy said, wow, that's a really good one. I said, yeah, but you didn't see all the bad ones before. And he laughed. He said, yeah, that's how it is. I said, I tried a lot of them before I got this good one. That's for sure. But, you know, don't give up so easy. Don't give up. You say, hey, I love this. I just shocked by all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creatoring. Wow, just shocked that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. So just imagine how you're going to feel if you can get this, smooth it out and do this. And you say, wow, I can hit some really good shots there. That's a real tough one. And I did it. That's how you gain confidence in yourself. You know, really confidence is like, I can do these even really tough shots. Maybe not every time, but I know I can do them. I know I can do them. It's doable. You know, it's doable. Like the real tough ones, I like get real wide stands and then I choke way down on the club. So I'm really close to the ground. And it's like, you know, it's a stream adaptation to the situation. And then just as much, you can be much more delicate when you're in that kind of situation. And then just kind of scrape it onto the green and it's up and then it all starts going down. And oh my goodness, they had the pins in like impossible places. And the greens are just baked and so fast. Holy cow. I mean, if you miss there and you think, oh, okay, I just missed. Like 20 feet away. Sometimes my ball was almost 30, 40 feet away. That's how steep the slope is. And I said, whoops, that's a little too hard. Yeah, 40 feet away. Oh, it was 40 feet too. Not good. You know, it's like, oh, gee. But everybody's in the same boat there. And don't even pay attention to whatever. It's, you know, just get better. Just get better. So don't worry if you mess it all up. That just shows that it's tough. You're doing something tough. You're trying something difficult. And when you get on the golf course, everything's difficult. Everything's difficult for some reason. I don't know why. It's just the way it is. So I don't want to think about that. So just shocked that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just allowing all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just accepting all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just delighting in all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just loving all guilt is an attempt to induce suffering in and abdication abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just loving all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just abiding in all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. So I had a little stumble there. That's fine. It's like, you know, like one chip does. It's not so good. See, I ran it by too far. That's okay. You know, let's get the next one. Let's see what, get adjusted a little better there. And kind of pay attention, a little bit of attention and a focus on this. You can't have your mind wandering, you know, when you're doing something like this. Just shocked by all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt and abdication in prime creating wow. Just shocked that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creating wow. Just shocked that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creating wow. Just shocked that all guilt is an attempt to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creating wow. So you have to have your attention on this. It's like a real delicate, difficult downhill chip, you know, side. It's like, boy, if I hit this too hard, it's gone. And if I hit it too easy, it's still in the rough. So, you know, it's like, I got to look at the trajectory. The trajectory, got to make, okay, what's trajectory? Okay, so when you see the trajectory, you know, it gives you a better idea of how hard you need to hit it to get that trajectory so it'll land on the green. So if you see it's kind of a high trajectory, say, I can pop this pretty good. It's not going to, you know, it's going to go more up than forward type of thing. But make sure then, you know, where the lie is, make sure you get under the ball. If it's sitting down far, you really got to gouge down into it. And if it's sitting high, you don't want to just sweep right underneath it. Then it won't go anywhere. So you have to assess where the ball is. You have to assess it like that. Yes, I talked to a friend and he's practicing chipping. He says, I got the yips. This is like a long, he says, I used to be so great at the short game. And now I've got the yips. I can't chip. It's either I'm gouging it fat or I'm blading it thin. The ball's, you know, going way too far. It just, I'm lost. And he says, it's so discouraging. I'm losing all my confidence. It's just destroying my confidence. Yeah, that's right. I've been there. I understand. It's not a good place to be. It's not a good place to be. And I told them, you need to practice more. Most people don't practice chipping because they don't allow it on the putting greens. But where I practiced, it's allowed. It's allowed. And so people do a lot of chipping practice, a lot of chipping practice. They know, because most players, amateurs, miss 75% of the greens they miss. So they only hit 25, a quarter of the greens. Quarter is like they hit maybe 14 greens and hit four greens in a round of golf, maybe. There's only four greens, you know, basically. Four to five greens. That's all. The rest of them, they're in the rough somewhere. They're off. They're going to have to chip or pitch, and you don't get to practice that at the practice facilities. So that they're lost. They're lost. They're lost. And I know, been there my whole life, because they never let you, can't practice. So I found a place where they let you practice this. I said, oh my God, this is like super helpful. Super, super helpful. And I've been practicing it ever since. I just love it. Realizing that this skill set is vitally important. If you want to play golf, you have to know, be a good chipper and pitter, chipper and pitcher, as well as a good putter. And most people are not at all. They go out and they just flounder. You know, I talked to another friend. He said, God, I hit the ball so great, but my short game was horrific and I'm so discouraged. I'm just bummed out and discouraged. I said, how often do you practice? He says, oh, never. You know, I said, dude, you know, you got to practice. You got to practice. Same thing with a spiritual situation, our suffering situation, you might say. Really, it's a suffering situation we're in here. Got to practice. And here we're inviting everyone to practice. That's what we do. So just shocked by all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt and abdication of prime creating wow. See, just shocked by renouncing all suffering wow. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering, wow. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering, wow. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering, wow. And you'd be surprised when you actually start doing this, you're going to start loving it. Because you say, hey, you know, this is a ticket to paradise. This is the ticket out of hell. You know, this is the ticket out of hell. And I can do it. I can do it. I can say just shocked by renouncing all suffering, wow. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Well, I can do that. But nobody ever told me I'm supposed to practice, you know, like this. Nobody said, no practicing allowed. You know, no chipping allowed. You go to the green, no chipping allowed. These signs all over the place. You know, I was like, are you kidding me? What's the big deal, you know? I mean, at a Muni course, I can see it's like really crowded and people are like beginners and they don't know what to do and they might hit people. But I mean, if you're at a place where people, like, it's a real tough course and there's skillful people play golf or they know what they're doing, it's fine. Everyone gets along. Everybody, there's all these people practicing. It's a beautiful thing because everyone's practicing a little something different angle, this and this and this. And, you know, but everyone gets along. Everyone manages around everybody else and like that. And there's no conflict going on at all. All different races are there. All different ages are there. You know, everyone is different there. And yet we all get along. There's no conflict. You know, if the guy's hitting balls out of the bunkers, I'm pitching. Someone else just chipping on the same green. I need to pick up my balls. He sees me and says, waits. You know, and I see someone else chipping. They want to pick up their balls. I say, got it. And they nod to me like that. So it's this wonderful etiquette and civility and etiquette that's going on this practice facility. Lots of people practicing, lots of people putting, and others are chipping and, you know, on the green. Different. But we see, okay, you're at that hole. You're going to go to this one. Okay, I got this one. Everybody understands, you know, and gives space for everyone else to be able to practice. This is called civilization. This is called civility. This is called cooperation. If somebody hits the ball too far, coming towards you, you stop it, you know, knock it back to them, they say thank you. Everyone's very polite, very polite. They know what you're here for. You know what they're here for. We're practicing. And it's just like a wonderful kind of unspoken camaraderie there that we all manage to fit in, and people make accommodations. Oh, you want to hit here? Fine. You know, I'll hit over here. Okay, great. You can always adjust. Like if this hole isn't open, this area, so I'll go over here. I'll go like that. And you know, you just have this etiquette. A couple of guys jumped on me. A couple of locals who I was pitching to this hole, chipping to this hole, and on the green. And these two guys came, and I guess they're like regulars. You know, they're kind of like real. You know, we're locals here, real regulars and locals, and this attitude, really kind of aggressive, like we're the boss, we're alpha males here, and they started just like walk around the green and start putting to the hole that I was chipping to. Well, that's never happened to me before, you know. And I didn't say anything, you know, I just let him putt, and then I just kept chipping to the hole. Didn't bother them, they didn't bother me. But that's first time it's ever happened, someone just jump on your hole like that. When they were getting ready to go play, and then they left and got play, I guess they felt that I, you know, I was just going to like defer to them or something. But I just like, you know, no, I can work around you, I'm competent enough, I'm not going to hit you or anything like that. That was an interesting situation. So they felt like, okay, I can't quite, you know, okay, push this person, bully this person, so to speak. But they were kind of like, you know, this is our place. This is our place. That's very rare. It's the first time it's ever happened here. This is our place. You know, we can do whatever we want to here. And I said, yeah, it's okay. If you're locals and stuff, that's fine. Do whatever you want to do. It's not stopping me. It's not stopping me. I'll keep practicing just fine. So they didn't bother me. You know, I didn't bother them. It's very interesting. I didn't say, what are you doing? You know, no. Just read the room. You know, these are like, you know, guys that feel they own the place. So let them have that attitude. That's fine. That's fine. Occasionally, I guess you would get something like that. But, you know, it wasn't unpleasant or anything like that. I just kept focused on what I was doing, you know, that's all. And then you get kids are there, and you know they don't know the etiquette. That's fine. You smile, and you work around them. And the parents are watching the kids, and they thank you, you know, thanks for, you know, working around them, you know, that kind of thing. Yeah, and everybody just gets along. So you have different types of people, but you know, it's a golf course. People don't get angry at a golf course. That's taboo. See, there's stuff that's taboo on a golf course, which is anger is taboo. You don't get angry. You don't yell at anybody. You don't be aggressive towards anybody. That is a gentleman's sport, so to speak. And you simply don't do that. I think I've only seen one time when somebody got angry on a golf course. I think only one time that there was a conflict between the people. And there's just one guy who's just, you know, he was just unhinged. But other than that, no, never, you know, never. You're always polite to people. You're always polite and civil. You give them their space. You respect their space, or you respect their person. You respect them. contrary to what's going on in the world, especially in the United States right now, right? That you know, doesn't exist on a golf course. So that's a golf course like an oasis, you know, a psychological oasis. There's people from all nationalities there. Indians were there. I interact with the Indians. There are a lot of Indians practicing. They're very nice, very, very, very polite, you know, and accommodating. There's people, all backgrounds. Vietnamese are there. Chinese are there. Japanese are there. All different races are there, actually. All different races are there. It's sort of a cosmopolitan kind of grouping of people. And ages groups and everything like that. And everyone just goes about their business and lets you go about your business. And fine. It's all smooth. You know, there isn't any of this race hustling going on the golf course there. Race baiting, race hustling. You know, all this kind of stuff of uncivility, you know, lack of respect. You know, we're supposed to respect everybody. You don't have nobody has a right to disrespect anyone. So, well, my, you know, grievance from 200 years ago, I get to disrespect you, not on a golf course. No, you don't do that. You don't bring your grievances of your great-great-great-grandparents to the golf course as an excuse to attack somebody, you know, something like that. See, it doesn't work that way. When you're there, you play by the rules, okay? The tradition and the rules. You're polite to everyone. You respect everyone. Very good training for all of us. For all of us. We all need this type of training. You know, I mean, you want to bring up your grievances? Well, the Irish, you know, the Irish grievances towards the English or something like that. You know, you don't do that. I'm not playing that English person or something, you know. It's golf, and you'd spend some time to realize, you know what? This is now. This is right now. And if we let our grievances overwhelm, you know, that right now, we're in a spiritual stone age. We're in a spiritual stone age, actually. And that's where the world's going, to a spiritual stone age. It's like the Middle East. I mean, they never run out of grievances, do they? And what's happened? Perpetual war. Look at Syria. Look at Syria, right? Look at the whole region. What is that from? Grievances. From when? The past. What you did back, you know, 300 years ago, or even 500 or 1500 years ago. And, you know, the whole purpose of Judeo-Christianity is what? Forgiveness. Forgiving grievances. Forgive grievances right now. Don't hold on to grievances. Course in Miracles by Jesus. What's one of his, you know, central themes is there's no cause for grievance. Let go of all grievances, all feelings of victimization and anger and grievances. You must let that go. You must let that go. He says, it's never justified, actually, he says. Grievances are never justified. So this is a training, a fantastic training we've been having for a couple thousand years. And even back before then, the Mosaic law of hey, you know, starting to cut down on grievances as much as possible. Start cutting down on grievances. Then Jesus came and said, okay, forgive everyone. Love everyone. Forgive and love everyone. That's your job here. So we made a tremendous amount of progress in that, and then codified all this into a law of due process for everyone. Everyone's equal under the law, due process under the law. You know, if there's a dispute, then it's judge, jury of your peers, judge it in a situation where they are under duress. The jury is not under fear for their lives, etc. And we try to then minimize grievance, and we accept the rule of law and the religious training of forgive everyone, because Jesus says all experiencing that we have is our own scripting, our own choice to experience this. Nobody causes anything in our lives. We're choosing to suffer. We're choosing to suffer in order to try and induce guilt in and displace the prime creatoring. Wow. We're all choosing this, volunteering to suffer, you might say. Every one of us. So your great-great-great-grandparents, they were volunteering to suffer back then. That's not anything you have to respond to or carry with you as some sort of revenge, you know, right now. There's the social justice is really a revenge movement. It's a grievance-based revenge movement is what it actually is. And your great-great-grandparents chose to suffer. just like you're choosing to suffer now. Okay, that sort of thing. All suffering is our choice, and it's a purposeful choice to try and induce guilt in and displace Prime Creator. Displace the Prime Creator, or induce guilt in and abdication of Prime Creatoring. Wow. Displacing a Prime Creatoring. Wow. Abdication of Prime Creatoring. Wow. Induce guilt in and abdication of Prime Creatoring. Wow. So the Prime, we're trying to get the Prime Creator to abdicate, to step down, step aside, step aside. And it doesn't work. So Jesus tells us, you know, don't play this game of thinking, hey, you know, I can build up enough suffering that this will displace the Prime Creator, you know. It'll produce enough guilt in the Prime Creator. So this is a negative game. This is a false, delusional game that's being played right now. So you can see it in the United States most severely right now. And people are like, what? You know, what is this? We're used to, you know, this is crazy. People are saying this is insanity. It is. It is literally insanity is what's going on. It's not social justice that's going on. It's insanity that's going on. Okay, no, but there's no such thing as victimization. Everyone chooses their own suffering, their own experiencing here, in order to try and apply, you know, induce guilt in the Prime Creator so the Prime Creator abdicates. It's a strategy. It's a strategy that we're using. So our job is to renounce suffering, is to renounce suffering, renounce our own suffering. That's everyone's job. Not say, you know, you're causing my suffering. You know, the police are causing my suffering. We need to restructure this. That's not our job. Our job is to renounce suffering. Renounce our own suffering. Renounce our own suffering. Just shock by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just shock by renouncing all suffering. Wow. I'm renouncing the whole purpose for suffering. It's intentional. Suffering is always intentional. It's our own intention. It's our imagination at play. And it's been that way all throughout history. So you go back, you know, as far as you want to go back, any person you want to talk about, whatever suffering they had at the so-called the hands of someone else, was indeed their own imagination, their own scripting, their own desire to try and induce guilt in and abdication of Prime Creatoring. And so there's a remedy for them. It's the same remedy, the remedy for us. Renounce all suffering. Renounce all suffering. Renounce all suffering. So really, the low road to hell is an attempt to, you know, give the wrong message, to insist upon the wrong road, insist that, you know, that our suffering should have brought about displacement of the Prime Creatoring, you know. So how, and so they're just symbolizing that. They're symbolizing that. It's being symbolized now. They want displacement. To say, hey, the suffering my ancestors finally is able to displace the Prime Creator, kind of thing like that. And they're symbolizing those who represent, like a representation of the Prime Creator, which is really white men, is how they're doing it. And saying, well, because white men are largely responsible for the fostering of Judeo-Christianity, right? And so they're saying, hey, you know, our suffering and the guilt and victimization, all this can bring about, you know, the displacement of the Prime Creator by extension, a symbol of the Prime Creator. So they're symbolizing, you know, who stands, who do we want to stand as a symbol for the Prime Creator, and then let's work on displacing them. Let's work on displacing them. Eventually, they'll just seize the homes and occupy. And that's what I saw in a dream. I went into my house and it was full of these people. I said, what's going on? And they said, well, it's our house now. It's our house now. So they want to just seize a property, seize possession, seize property like that. And, you know, just walk into a neighbor. I like this house, and walk in the house. Now it's my house. That's why they're trying to defund, get rid of the police, get rid of the legal system, you know, all this kind of stuff that's taking place right now. Ultimately, it's going to lead to them just displacing the people from their homes, actually. And then everyone will be too frightened to do anything about it. It's all a drama. It's all a drama. It's dramatizing in a symbolic way of the success that we can displace the Prime Creator, you know. Or at least we're displacing their messengers of the Prime Creator, so to speak. Symbolizing it. It's all a silly game. So what the right way to go about it is to just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. So when people ask, how bad is it going to get? That's how bad it's going to get. The grievance mongers will just simply, just displace you out of your home. Of course, who's going to pay the utility bills at that point, you know? Well, they'll displace, you know, your money too. They'll figure out a way to get, you know, give us all your money, give us your home, give us all your money. You got nothing, and we have it all. That kind of thing. it's a drama that, you know, symbolic drama of like, hey, we can displace the Prime Creator, sort of thing, but not possible to displace the Prime. The Prime Creator cannot abdicate. It's not possible. We cannot induce guilt in the Prime Creator, and the Prime Creator cannot abdicate. So it's all the suffering, imaginary suffering, is just a silly, useless scheme, arrogant scheme to try and displace the Prime Creator, and so we can be the new Prime Creator. It simply doesn't work. It doesn't work. So, you know, there is, you know, very extreme situations on the horizon, which culminate in just simply, you know, seizing property possessions and money from people that, you know, mostly white people actually will have their property and homes seized. And people are feeling this now. They realize this heading in a really extreme direction right now. Extreme direction. Similar to Germany, where, you know, the property, the homes and money and property of the Jews were seized. It's very similar, except maybe on a larger scale going to take place here. So we have to be very clear about, you know, what the answer actually is, so we don't think like maybe they're right, you know, maybe that's right. No, it's not right. It's an utter useless delay tactic, extreme arrogance, and not the teaching of Jesus at all. Not the teaching of Jesus at all. So just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow, just allowing, renouncing of all suffering. Wow, just accepting, renouncing of all suffering. Wow, just delighting and renouncing of all suffering. Wow, just loving, renouncing all suffering. Wow, just abiding and renouncing all suffering. Wow, just renouncing all suffering. Wow, just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. So indeed, it's a very serious situation that's gone on in the U.S. Very serious. And it's a road that's low road to hell is taking place right here. And hell is the belief that there is a way to induce guilt in and abdication of the Prime Creator. That's what hell is. There's a belief there's a way to do it. So of course we'll then say, oh gee, you know, let's keep working at this. Let's keep working at this. There is no way to do it. So we don't need to keep working at it. There's no purpose to keep working at it. No purpose whatsoever. So with these powerful techniques from the revelations that we're having here, this powerful practice techniques, the more we practice, the more confident we'll feel like, you know what, there's going to be some way to sidestep all this trouble. It's kind of like I'm feeling, you know, practicing. I say, well, you know what? If I'm out on a golf course, you know, I'm gonna be, you know, be able to keep my game together. You might say, I'll be able to keep my game together. I don't want to think about it. I get nervous. Like, it's like, what happened to my game? But if you really practice, you know, more and more and more, and It just means I'm not quite there yet. I just have to keep dialing in stuff and getting it more, you know, better technique. And just like here, we have a technique, just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Okay. Don't be thinking, what do I need to think about? This. Say, no, I know what the practice is. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. This anchors, you know, anchors the truth in you. It anchors you. So if I am on a golf course, you know, I've never done any of this stuff before, but pace off, how far is the pin from the edge of the green? Pace it off. It's like I say, it's 15 steps. Okay. And I'm like 10 yards, 10 steps off. Okay. That's like a three, two sort of thing. 3-2, like 3-2. So what club you hit with a 3-2 like that? 10 yards off, you know, probably 3-2 would be a 56 degree sandwich. I'd use a sandwich there for chipping or pitching sandwich. Yeah, 3-2. Go with a sandwich. You know, get those sort of ratios so you can give yourself a pretty good approximation of what you need to do here. Whereas before I just sort of eyeball it and say, and I just, you know, I wouldn't think about anything except how do I deal with this? But so you have to have some technique there. So, you know, kind of like, I know what I'm doing here. Okay. Let's get the right ratio. Okay. What kind of swing of the grass and this and this and this, and start, you know, eliminating all sorts of iffy stuff. And say, okay, I got this shot dialed in. And then it's a matter of executing it at that point. And, you know, if you do a good job, it's going to be a good result. If you flub it a little bit, you know, say, I could have done better. But say, okay, could have done better on that one. And, you know, the angle was not quite, I didn't follow through enough. I didn't pop it enough or something. But then practice kind of before you hit it, you know, okay, I'm going to pop through it and follow through like this, follow through, you know, what's the follow, make sure you like that, and then do the best you can do. But at least you know, like, what your routine is, like how to dial yourself into the situation. So it's important to do that. You don't want to just like be in a hurry, say, I gotta hit the ball, go, gee, I'm in a tough spot, okay, let me just try to hit it and get it close, and oops, that wasn't good. And then you start thinking like, I can't, this situation's too difficult for me. No, dial in the situation. Oh, but I'm not good enough to do that, blah, blah, blah. Well, if you practice like this, you will be good enough. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow, because all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creatoring. Wow, which is impossible. Prime creator cannot abdicate. Cannot say, I'm not the prime creator anymore. No. Prime creator has to always be the prime creator. There's no way to abdicate. But there's no guilt in the prime creator, because the prime creator is always yes, always yes, always yes. Always on this yesing light. So it's just saying yes to all. It's just perpetual yes to all. There's no feeling of guilt in the prime creator. We can't induce guilt in the prime creator. So all this suffering is useless. So just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. 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 And you know, it helps when you're practicing. If you like, you're dressed like you've been playing golf for a long time. You know how to dress. Your clubs, bag, everything. Like, this guy's a player. You know, he knows what he's doing. And people respect that. You know, people say to me, oh, thank you, sir. Or, okay, so, you know, they could tell that they're like, oh, this guy, you know, is dialed in. This guy's focused on being dialed in. And he's done a lot of work to get dialed in. So people respect that. They respect it. They say, okay, great. It is possible. But if you just go out there and you look like you don't know what you're doing, you know, then you feel like, geez, you know, it's intimidating, kind of. It's just like, huh. So I noticed that I always dress well and present well and go about my business like I'm, you know, I'm just humble and quiet and just there for serious practice and all this stuff. And you know, and then people just, you know, accept you. Say, okay, this guy belongs here. It's no problem. So that it helps to do that. So, you know, just be serious and humble and practice. Serious and humble and practice. Get better and better and better. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just shocked by all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt. And abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just shocked that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just shocked that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just shocked that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Just shocked that all suffering is an attempt to induce guilt in and abdication of prime creatoring. Wow. Okay. Just be, you know, humble. And you know, present yourself in such a way as you're not interested in being dispossessed and suffering, going down the road to hell. You're not interested in the road to hell. So take care of yourself. You know, eat in a real healthy way. Yeah, be neat and clean, and walk with, you know, quiet confidence, be nice, civil to people, good sense of humor, and you're not interested in going down the road to hell. You're not interested in trying to use suffering to induce guilt in an abdication of prime creatoring. You're not interested in that. And I try not to bother people from other traditions, you know, spiritual, religious traditions. Nobody's doing this, what we're doing here. Nobody else is doing this right now. Not really. It's very different what they're doing, actually. So it's here. It's just renounce all samsara. Just shocked by renouncing all samsara. Samsara-ing. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all samsara-ing. Wow. You're not trying to cure it, you know, get free of it. We're renouncing it. Get free of it. What is that? You know, then you know, then where is it? Where did it come from? And where are we that we're free of it? What happened to it? And all that stuff. We're renouncing it. We're the ones who are using it. It's just a tool. Samsara is just a tool we're using to try to induce guilt in an abdication of the prime creatoring. So the right thing to do, the honest thing to do, is renunciation of samsara. Not I'm trying to stabilize my mind, you know, I'm trying to cure. I'm still trying to find a cure for samsara. Don't find a cure for suffering. Don't find a cure for it. Renounce it. So this is, I've never heard this directly like this before. But again, you know, it's like in golf, I putt cross-handed. Like Jordan Spieth putts cross-handed. Nobody even talks about it, but he does. And he was the best putter maybe we've ever seen. He's not quite as good now, but putting cross-handed, I make a lot more putts. I'm a lot better putter, really good putter cross-handed. But it's unorthodox. So people are like, yeah, I tried that once. I did good, but, you know, it's hard to do what's unorthodox here. It's very difficult. But I say, you know, I'm going to keep putting cross-handed because I putt really, really very well doing that. So people may not be practicing this way. It may seem unorthodox. Hey, it's a time to be unorthodox right now, right? Either be unorthodox or perish, you know. Be unorthodox or go on the road to hell. So don't try to get free of samsara. Renounce samsara. Don't try to cure samsara. Renounce samsara. Okay, renounce it. Meaning, it's my baby. I'm the one who brought it about, and I brought it about in an attempt to, you know, get the prime creator to abdicate. That's why. So you're taking responsibility for samsara. Instead of saying, well, I have no idea where it came from. I don't understand. But if I just calm my thoughts down, I'll be fine, blah, blah, blah. No, we know exactly where it came from, exactly why we have it. It's our ploy to try to induce guilt in the prime creator. So the prime creator abdicates, says, I can't stand this guilt. It's too much. I'm going to abdicate. And then I'll get free of the guilt. It's an intentional strategy on our part. Samsara is our intentional strategy to bring about the abdication of the prime creator. So we can be the new prime creator. That's why it came. People say, well, it's mysterious. You know, why are we, you know, deluded? It's not mysterious at all. There's no mystery to it. There's no mystery to it. So just renounce it. Renounce it. So this, you know, people say, this is going really fast. Yeah, it is. You have to go really fast right now. You have to. And it's not that fast. It's not too fast. You know, it's stable. It's like that Corvette. I said, well, it's going super fast, but I can see it's very stable. Very, very stable. Amazing. It's like glued to the ground. You know, it's like, wow. The people I've talked to, the car people, they said the new Corvettes are really something. They're really, really something. They're extremely fast and powerful and well designed. You know, it's but yeah, it's ridiculously, you know, powerful. But they do stick like glue to the road. You know, it's amazing. And so we're sticking like glue to the road. We've got stability with what we're doing. Just renouncing all, just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all samsaring. Wow. Samsaraing. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all delusioning. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all delusioning. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all mayaing. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all to self-deceptioning. Wow. Don't cure the self-deception. Don't fix it. Don't get free of it. Renounce it. We're not trying to get free of it. We're renouncing it. There's a big difference. We're free of it. Where did it come from? And where did it go? And where am I now? No. We're renouncing it. It's our child. We're renouncing this, you know, this idea, this strategy. It's a strategy on our part. We're renouncing this strategy. We're renouncing this strategy. So we're owning it, you know, own it and renounce it. When we renounce it, we're owning it. This is our strategy. This is what we've been trying to do. We've been trying to induce guilt in the prime creator so the prime creator would abdicate. That's a strategy in order to displace the prime creator. That's where all the stuff comes from. And from nowhere else. And from nowhere else. And each one of us chose to try and, you know, play a role in this. Try to play a role. Let's see if we can collectively, you know, make this happen. Make it happen. So each one of us can decide to stop volunteering to play a role in this and renounce this strategy. Renounce this strategy. Renouncing the strategy of suffering. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing the strategy of suffering. Wow. Just accepting, renouncing the strategy of suffering. Wow. Just my strategy is my strategy. You know, it's each one of us has chosen. It's just shocked by renouncing the strategy of suffering. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing the strategy of suffering. Wow. So huge, huge, fast progress here, you might say. Really, 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 like that. And it's kind of like the golf also, really fast progress. It's like, whew. Okay, you know, it's like, what's going to be the next progress? I don't know. Whatever, I got to think about it. But, you know, really fast progress, like say, okay, wow, I can really pitch the ball close, actually, from 20 yards out. You know, I was getting it real close. You know, within putting range, you can make the putts. I can make those putts. There's, you know, within 5 feet, pretty much, most of the shots from 20 yards out. So that's playing. You know, that's good. That's good. But of course, you've got it dialed in because you're hitting shot after shot. But in the golf course, every single situation's different. You know, it's like it's a brand new situation for you, and so it's not, you're not dialed into it. So the thing is how do I get dialed in, you know, to a different situation? That's something to practice. Like move your spot every single time. Hit one shot, move your spot. Hit another, move your spot. So you get used to, God, there's a new situation. I got to assess it properly. That's real practicing. I got to do that. That's tough. You got to, you have to have some confidence that you can succeed at that, right? Or it's just going to be overwhelmingly difficult. Wow, that's interesting. Yeah. Because that's how it actually is out on the course. You only get one chance. Every situation is a new, different situation. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just shocked by renouncing all strategy of suffering. Wow. I'm waiting for a call for work. There's no work. You know, that's another issue. Just no work right now. Wow. Crazy. Suffering. So just shocked by renouncing all strategies of suffering. Wow. Just loving renouncing all strategy of suffering. Wow. Just loving renouncing all strategy of suffering. Wow. So has not been easy to get to this point where we can go like real fast like this because it's unorthodox. But the people in orthodoxy right now, you know, they're just struggling. They're flailing, and they don't have a game. They don't have the game for what's going on in the world right now. They just don't have the game for it. This is nasty business that's going on in the world. The grievance mongers, you know, the revenge seekers, the shrill revenge seekers, the systematic racism. That's revenge. From the past. What? Suffering. Where does suffering come from? It's our own strategy. Renounce the strategy of suffering. Don't try to take revenge that someone caused my suffering. Everyone chooses to play a role here, volunteers to play a role, a suffering role here, to try and induce guilt in and displace an abdication of prime creator. Okay, that's what everyone comes here to do. So, you know, that's their business. You know, the suffering of your ancestors, that's their business. They say, well, that caused my suffering now. No, it didn't. We chose to play a role, volunteered to play a role here of suffering. And they said, okay, this is a good place to suffer. I'm going to choose this role. Like that. And there are those who are starting to renounce suffering, maybe. So maybe they're not going to be suffering so much. They said, you know what? I'm tired of the strategy of suffering. I want to repent. And maybe they've been working for lifetimes on repentance. Okay? So look at it and say, hey, I can get here also. Pay attention. It's a tough road, you know, and so those who show the way, you know, hey, realize, hey, this is helpful. This is very, 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 very helpful. That kind of attitude, you know, the attitude of gratitude. And gratitude is always expressed through what? Practicing. The attitude of gratitude is always the best expression. The only expression really that's really helpful is your own practicing. That's the attitude of gratitude. No practicing, no real gratitude, actually. Just shocked by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just loving renouncing all suffering. Wow. So again, gotta go fast now. So I've certainly given years and years and years and years and years a lead up to this to get everyone up to speed so you'd actually be able to go fast now, really fast, which means practice every day. Most, you know, do as much as you can every day of practicing at this point. And we have the practices available now that will give you that speed that you need. Just renounce, just shock by renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just allowing, renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just accepting, renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just delighting and renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just loving, renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just abiding and renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Just renouncing all suffering. Wow. Okay, that's a super, super fast way to go towards renouncing suffering. Now, we're told if we have the willingness to renounce suffering, the willingness that this is sufficient, you know, this build up your willingness, that there will be a response from the grace of the great perfection, grace of the prime creator. There'll be a response. This is what I'm, of course, counting on. A super beneficial response, but we do have to build up our willingness. So we say, yeah, we can accept this, you know, this great helpfulness. We don't have to work on trying to, is suffering illusion stuff? Just renounce it. Just renounce it all. It's a strategy. So, you know, of course it's all imaginary strategy, of course, but don't spend worry about all time. We already know it's all imaginary. That doesn't make it go away. It won't go away until we renounce it. You might be able to see through this is all illusion and stuff, but then it comes back on you. It's illusion, but I've seen through it many times. It comes back. But if we renounce it, then that's a whole different story. We don't need it anymore. It can't help but go away then. Genuine renunciation. So I can't wait to see, you know, how the day will play out in the next day. It's like, yeah, we get some rain here Sunday, something that we haven't seen in a long time. So spring's playing out. Kind of cool now, like low 70s. People would find this very, very pleasant here, very, very pleasant indeed. And yet we're spending our time practicing now. Go fast. Even if you're achy, I mean, even though I'm achy, again, 4 out of the last 6 days I've practiced golf, for instance. And the legs and the body is just, you know, achy and tired and stuff. But I say, well, I can still go out. Let's still go out there and let's, you know, let's push it. Let's get better. Do I feel I'm good enough? No, I don't feel I'm good enough at this point. Have to keep pushing, you know, parameters a little bit and get better at it. But, you know, just try not to have any idea of, you know, what to do. Just show up. Showing up is, you know, is more than half the battle, actually. Show up, get out there, say, okay, let me do it. And gradually you say, okay. And you gradually say, okay, this is how I can use my time really in a good way here. So just show up. Show up to practice. That's how to go fast. Don't show up to tell anybody how wonderful they are. Show up to practice. Don't show up to tell everybody how wonderful you are. Show up to practice. Nobody cares how wonderful you are on a golf course. Hey, everybody, here I am, you know. I'm really great, you know. Nobody's going to pay any attention to you. They don't care. What's that have to do with them? You can't golf their ball, you know. So you show up there to practice. People then, you know, they respect that. We're all working on our game here. You know, everybody's working. Everybody's struggling. Everybody's struggling at a golf course. So they understand, you know. I hit one too far. No, the guy was putting on the hole, and I was waiting for him. And he goes, oh, I'm not in your way, am I? And I said, no, I'm just waiting. I'm just waiting for you because, like I said, object fixation. You know, if I see an object, the ball's going to go there, right? He says, we've all been there, right? And he goes, yeah, we certainly have. And so in other words, you know, the trauma is there. You know, it's like everybody's there has been traumatized. It's rehab. It's trauma rehab, basically. Yeah. If you're a golfer, you're always in trauma rehab. That's true. That's true. I want to avoid traumatization in the future. It is. It's like I talked to some. How'd you do? I shot a 91 or something, but I got an 8 on one hole and a 7 on another. You know, it's like that's what he's thinking about. I said, my God, I just like all hell broke loose for me there. You know, I was doing great, and then suddenly all hell broke loose. And that's what they remember. You know, it's like scar tissue. It's like traumatized. It's like, ah. I don't know, it's real bad, real bad. So, we're all there in rehab. Especially the older people. The younger people are still thinking like, I'm just one shot away from it all coming together. And the older people are like, it never happened, you know, it never happened. But you know, probably didn't practice right when you were young, didn't practice right. Yeah, the kids, you know, they just love showing off and having fun, but do they really practice in a way that's just elevating their game, you know? But, you know, your kids, you know, having fun is how they keep their interest engaged, that sort of thing. It's very rare to get someone who's like super serious at doing what all the good stuff, like Tiger Woods was from the day he was born. You know, he was practicing like crazy. In fact, he would practice in his garage. He wouldn't even eat. His mom had to come in and bring him food. He wouldn't stop to eat. Seriously. That's Tiger Woods. He would not stop even to eat. That's how focused he was as a young kid, and never stopped that focus. Yeah, so, yeah, serious talent there. And that's, yeah, to say the least. Wow. You say, wow. It was a great experience watching Tiger Woods play live, you know, follow him around and just like, wow. You just feel it, you know, you just feel it, man. It's like, wow, this guy's dialed in. He is really dialed in. Very impressive to just get that feel of someone who's so intensely dialed in. You feel the vibe of that. You feel the confidence. You feel his dialed-in-ness. It's just who he is. There's no such thing as not being dialed in, you know? It's that kind of thing. It's just automatic dialed-in-ness there. And just as he's walking, he's still dialed in. He's constantly dialed in. And I'm just like, you know, watching him, walking along with him and watching him hit and stuff. It's like, wow, that's amazing. Tom Watson was that way too. I walked with him along a golf course, Tom Watson. I was shocked that this guy's, what is this guy? Some alien or something? He's so dialed in and confident. Holy smokes. Oh my God. He's just different breed, you know, a different breed, you might say, like a border collie. He's just like so focused on what he was doing. But no, Tiger's different. Tiger's like magisterially dialed in. You know, it's just everything's going to go my way. Everything is going to go my way because I know how to make it go my way. I know how to, and it's just the confidence is just, and the other players felt it. They just felt this. Oh my gosh, you know. And it psychologically affected them profoundly. I can understand that. Any people would play with them on the final round, they just fall apart. They just fall apart. There's this force field, you know, of dialed inness. But really nice, you know. Or you can get inspired by it also. You can probably, you know, I think you should play better when you're with someone like that. You should play better with someone when someone's like that. But of course, you end up being a spectator and forget your own business. You know. But maybe be inspired to get dialed into your business, right? So let's get.